So we have to take the bolster. Okay, the kid should be sitting on the bolster. Okay, we have to put some toys, a small bench. Okay, in front of the kid, put some toys, some sound making toys, some toys which are good and colorful. So where the kid should look, don't put toys which are not attractive, which are not good. Don't put routine toys. Put some new toys so that the child will get good attention. Okay, so the child will be looking at the toys and playing with the toys. The therapist should be sitting behind, supporting at the pelvis level. Okay, make sure that the child vision should be focusing on the toys. Okay, then slowly shift the bolster towards left and towards right. Understood? So by this, what happens? It helps to improve the balance of the core muscles. Understood what I'm talking? So I am moving towards left and towards right. But the kid should be focusing on playing with the toys in front. Understood what I'm talking? So this is the first activity. Sitting on the bolster with vision down on a toy, give full support, ask the child to maintain the balance by moving the bolster. So basically, it helps to improve the balance. So we are focusing on improving the balance, the core, the spinal aspect. This is simple exercises. Sitting on the ball with vision down on the book, give slow perturbations and ask the child to maintain balance. This exercise also is equal to this bolster exercise, but only difference is we are taking a physio ball. We are taking a physio ball. We are making the kid sit on the physio ball. Okay. The therapist should be behind, supporting at the pelvis level. Okay. So someone should be there in front of the child. Okay. Should showing some toys. Okay. Some any kind of activity. The kid should be looking at that object or that person. So we have to move the ball towards right and left, front and back, so that we have to give small perturbations. Perturbations means slight movement towards right or left or front or back. So by that we are facilitating the core muscles. We are improving the balance of the core muscles. Okay. So that is about the second exercise. The third exercise, sitting on a high bench, moving the lower extremity in air, this helps in postural control. This is also a very simple exercise. For that, you need a bench, a high bench. Okay, the feet should not touch the floor. Okay, that is very, very important. So it is very, very simple. Just move one lower limb on top of the other. Okay. But what is the use of this activity in India? Why I have to take one limb and put lower limb on other lower limb? Because when I am sitting like this, okay, my base of support is big. When I am lifting my leg, my base of support is becoming small. When my base of support becomes small, I have to use my trunk muscles to maintain balance. See, sitting like this is easy for me. Muscles, less muscles will work. When I'm lifting and putting this leg, okay, the base of support, my buttocks, only half of the buttocks is supporting. So I need more muscle work to maintain my balance. Understand what I'm talking? So basically, it is one kind of, you know, to improve the balance activities. Understand what I'm talking? But important thing, the feet should not touch the floor. The feet should be on the air. Okay? So that is about the exercise. So next is help them to gain independent sitting control. Okay. These kids doesn't have sitting control. So please train these kids in good sitting control. So how we can train? So we can use benches, we can use any kind of static surfaces. After that we can use bolsters and physio balls. Always first start with static surface. So please take any kind of a static surface. It can be a chair, a stool, but please make sure that there should not be any kind of back support. Okay, so assist the child to get independent sitting control. Okay, so the therapist should be in front of the child, assisting the kid to maintain the trunk, the head and neck, and the lower limbs in proper alignment. So once the kid gets good sitting control, we can train for reaching out activities. Ask the kid for reaching out activities. So it helps to improve the dynamic balance. Okay. Once the kid attains the sitting control in static surface, we can take this kid to dynamic surface. We can use bolsters. We can use physio balls. So in that also, go for reaching out activities, throwing activities. All those things will help to improve the trunk muscles, especially the abdominals and the back extensors. So the kid also will learn how to sustain the trunk, because sustaining the trunk is very, very important for sitting, standing and walking activities. So the same thing I said, so perturbations on rigid surface. Okay, so perturbations means balance, slight balance activities. So instead of that, we can ask the kid to take any kind of toys, any kind of ball, or even we can ask the kid to throw any kind of basketball or any kind of any plastic balls or any kind of small toys also the kid can play. We have to train for standing activities. Okay, so when we are training for standing activities, we can use walkers, even we can use any kind of physio balls. Okay, so that, but when you are training for standing activities, please make sure that the alignment is proper. The alignment of head and neck, the alignment of the spine, the alignment of the hip joint. One of the important thing, if the child doesn't have good sitting control, okay, don't go for standing activities more. Try to do more activities in sitting. Once the sitting has become better, then go train for standing activities. For standing activities, we can use walkers, we can use even parallel bars, even we can use any kind of physio balls, so that the child will support the physio ball. The therapist should be behind, assisting at the pelvis level and facilitating the abdominal muscles. Okay, so in standing activities, there are some standing activities, reaching out activities you can do on this. You can see this picture. Okay, so the therapist is behind. Okay, we are putting some balls or toys, asking the kid to bend, take the toys, come up and throw it. Understood? So by doing this, we are trying to facilitate the trunk muscles. We are trying to facilitate the lower limb muscles, so that the child will get good balance in walking. So these are some of the activities, dynamic functional activities we have to train before walking. There are some other activities we can train for these kids. We can ask the kid to walk on cushions. Cushions means any kind of soft surface, because it helps to improve the balance. We can ask the kid to walk on beams. Beams means a narrow path. We have to walk on that. It is very difficult for these kids, but we can train them to walk slowly. Jumping on the trampoline. You know what is trampoline? Trampoline, we say, we can jump on that, the kid will come up. It is one kind of fun. It will be in the gardens, all those things. That is called trampoline. Next is, we can ask the kid to climb up the ladders, staircase climbing and swinging activities. All these activities we can incorporate in these ataxic cerebral palsy kids. Okay, so we have any queries and questions?